these cramps, you know. I should have asked for a doctor earlier. He could have saved her if I'd called him before.
It's not your fault, Doreen.
I had a baby once, you know. I saw her. I wasn't supposed to because she was up for adoption. But one of the nurses took me down to the nursery. And I saw her. I wasn't allowed to hold her or anything like that. Just look at her through the glass. She was beautiful.
Don't upset yourself, Doreen. You need to rest.
I never saw her again after that. That nurse, she said she'd take me again when she was on duty. But by then, they'd taken her away to her new mum and dad. It was all right, though, because they could look after her and love her and give her everything. I couldn't. I didn't have anything to give her. Not even a family.
Cry it all out, Doreen. You'll have a baby one day.
No, I won't. That's what the doctor said. He said, because I had so much trouble carrying this one, I'll never have a baby at all.
Everything was going on all right until you poked your nose in. I don't know why you couldn't have minded your own business. After all, he's my son, my responsibility.
That is quite enough, Jones. Now then, what is the problem?
My son is not in need of care and protection.
Then how did he get this black eye, eh? Did he walk into a lamppost?
Look, you're not going to break up our family just because my sister lost her temper once.
Yesterday, Danny said that his aunt hit him more than once.
That's not true. Now, is it Danny?
No, she only hit me once. Just got mad at me.
Then why did you run away?
Please, this is not getting us anywhere. Jones, I suggest that you let...
Mrs. Hampshire,
take Danny home and talk to your sister. Let her decide the best course of action.
I don't have much of a choice, do I?
I assure you, Mrs. Jones, putting Danny into a home is a last resort. Look, let me talk to your sister, assess the situation at home, then I'll come back and talk to you. I promise you no permanent action will be taken without your knowledge, and I hope your approval.
I'll never agree to putting him in a home. I'm getting out of here soon.
Then I'm sure it won't be necessary. Come on, Danny, you can show me where your aunt lives, can't you?
Mum? Oh, do as I told you, Danny. Now go back to Aunt Sheila's and stay there until I get out of here. And don't make trouble. Understand?
Yeah.
We always act in the child's best interest, Mrs. Jones. Let's go, Danny.
See you, Mum.
Bye, love. And be good.
Mr. Fletcher, take Jones back to her duties and then report back to me, please.
Come on, Jones.
Are you his aunt?
No, I'm from child welfare.
A good thing. He needs to be taken in hand.
Oh, get lost.
That's enough from you, young man.
You can take your morning tea break now.
No, it's not for another half hour, Miss Bennet.
I may not be around in half an hour to stand in for you. Now get going.
Okay.
Well, good morning, Miss Bennet. I've come to have another chat with Tracy Morris.
Yes, I'll get her.
Unless, of course, you have something else to tell me.
No, it was just that, I was thinking over your offer.
And?
Well, we must help the police all we can, mustn't we? It's part of the job.
Well, I'm sure that with you and I on her trail, she won't hold out for long.
Now, Mr. Fletcher, I wonder if you could explain to me why you have involved yourself so much with Jones. It's all very well to be concerned about the prisoners, but I think it's a bit much to stick your nose in where it's not wanted.
I know it's none of my business, Mrs. Davidson. It's a job that our social worker should be doing. But we don't have a social worker, thanks to the staff here. Now, if you remember rightly, it was your suggestion at the last classification meeting that we try and help the prisoners wherever we can.
I am well aware of that, Mr. Fletcher. My concern is that your interference may have alienated Jones. She is due for parole in a couple of weeks, and I would not like to see her lose it. Excuse me. Erica Davidson? Yes? What happened? Yes. Yes, I see. Yes, very well. I'll tell him. Goodbye. Well, apparently Jones is not the only one you've alienated. That was Mrs. Hampshire. Danny jumped out of the car when she stopped at the traffic lights. He's run away again. Mr. Fletcher, you will be responsible for telling Jones. After this, I doubt very much whether Danny will ever risk visiting his mother again.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing when morning comes around.